WFN YouTube channel is incredibly happy and delighted to introduce our viewers to Dr. Daniel Gams Massey from Cameroon, who is the current General Secretary for African Academy of Neurology. Daniel, very good morning to you.
Good morning, Prof. Chisa. I'm happy to be here. It is an honor for me to be in the channel of the WFN.
Tell us about who you are and where you are from, and when did you decide to be interested in medicine, and how did your journey start in neurology? What inspired you to be interested in brain?
Okay, so I'm a Cameroonian coming from Cameroon. I've did all my primary and secondary school in Cameroon. I've decided to go through medical study because of my parents, especially my mother, who was a nurse. She was very delighted and very dedicated to her work. So I've learned from her how to love people, how to help people to improve, how to contribute to the healing of disease, and that's why I've chose to go through medical training. I did my medical training in the Faculty of Medicine and Biomedical Science in the University of Yaoundé 1, which is the capital of Cameroon. And after my medical training, I've been posted as a civil servant, because in Cameroon, when you have finished your medicine training program, you have to work as a civil servant before going to specialization, if you want to specialize. So I've been posted in the southwestern part of Cameroon, especially in the city of Bouya, in a regional hospital, where I face a lot of challenges, especially with poor patients. So
tell us a bit about this hospital, Danny. What sort of hospital was it? What sort of patients did you used to see?
Yeah, the Regional Hospital of Bouya is a hospital located in the semi-urban area. Mm-hmm. The hospital receive a lot of patients coming from village, and so they usually don't have enough money to afford either complementary exam, either treatment. So you have to manage them with very little diagnosis tools and very little treatment options. It was a big challenge for me, but I've also learned a lot from them.
So on a typical
so
day,
after my A typical day in the Regional Hospital of Bouya was we usually start by a round ward where we see patient hospitalized. Mm-hmm. And after that, we used to see patient in the outpatient department. So we used to start like the work at 7 o'clock a.m. Mm-hmm. And usually end like 6 p.m. because we used to have a huge amount of patients. My average number of patients was about 50 patients daily, which was a huge number for me.
Both outpatients, yes. And inpatients, or inpatients 50 and outpatients 50?
Outpatient department only, 50 patients. Yes.
And your inpatient ward round also probably 50 to 100 patients that you have to see every day?
No. In the ward, we had like 40 patients hospitalized. Mm-hmm. And in our patient department, we had like 50 patients see a day.
Right. So you spent a couple of years in this hospital. What sparked you to be interested in brain? That's that story.
My love of brain started very early. Mm-hmm. Because in the secondary school I had a member of my family who was diagnosed of epilepsy. Mm-hmm. In that time, epilepsy was a big stigmatizing mm-hmm. disease in our country. So the whole family suffer from that stigmatization. That's why I've decided to learn how to diagnose mm-hmm. and how to treat epileptic patient with epilepsy, especially starting from my family member who was mm-hmm. a patient with epilepsy.
The getting into neurology training, was it challenging or was it a reasonably easy path for you to get into neurology training in Cameroon?
No, I did not complete my neurology training in Cameroon. I went to Senegal. Mm-hmm. It was easy for me to apply for it. Mm-hmm. It was very good experience for me to apply for the neurology training program in Senegal. And the response came very earlier, and then I just left Cameroon to Senegal where I did my neurology training program, and I was there with you probably know Professor Amadou Gallo Diop, mm-hmm. Professor Mansour Ndiaye, the first president of African Academy of Neurology, and other mentor in Senegal. I spent like 5 years there where I also complete an epileptology training program and a clinical neurophysiology training program.
Mm-hmm. When you come back to when you came back to Cameroon after your 5 years of training, did you have access to EEG machines and EMG machines or did you have trouble setting those things up?
Yes, actually, where I'm actually in Douala, so I leave Senegal directly from Douala, is like an economic capital of the Cameroon. So mm-hmm. it's the greatest city of the country with the main hospital, the biggest hospital in the country, the Douala General Hospital, where I'm actually working as a consultant neurologist. So when I came back, I just found almost diagnostics tools that was available, like MRI machine, like mm-hmm. CT scan, like EEG, mm-hmm. and also EMG. So mm-hmm. all these diagnostic tools were available in my setting. But I'm lucky. I can say that I'm lucky because when I compare this hospital with the other part of other hospital and other part of Cameroon, we are very lucky because mm-hmm. in some region, there is no neurologist. Mm-hmm. In some region, there is no CT scan. Mm-hmm. We cannot talk about MRI there. There is no EEG machine. So I'm very lucky to be here.
That's great to hear. And
so my last it's question. Also in, to help those people who are not mm-hmm.
Outside of anything, Denny, what sort of interest do you have?
I didn't get the point, please.
Outside medicine, tell us about your personal life.
Okay.
What do you do other than neurology and other than promoting brain health in Africa?
Okay, I'm a young Cameroonian. I'm married with a beautiful lady. I have three kids, two boys and one pretty girl.
Oh, yeah.
And yes, and they give me a lot of peace. They give me a lot of happiness too.
Do you have any other interests like music, reading, movies, things like that also?
I also like literature. Mm-hmm. I like to read a lot of books, and these are my main interests apart from neurology.
My final question, what is your message to young Cameroonians and young medical students who are out there in African Academy Neurology Territory country, especially Sub-Saharan Africa and other places? Why should they be interested in a career in neurology?
My main message is that neurology is an inspiring domain of medical science. Neurology is a wide, broad domain with lot of challenge and also a lot of opportunities. Neurology have a lot of opportunities. And also we have to think about our population. There is a huge need of neurology in our population in almost all countries in Africa. So we need more young people to be engaged, more young people to be volunteer to do neurology so that they will help their family, they will help the population, they will help their country, and they will contribute to the development of Africa.
Absolutely, Danny. Neurological disorders are the leading cause of disability worldwide and second leading cause of death. And it affects brain. Our brains make us who we are. Without our brain, yeah. We are nothing. So the neurology, yeah. Profession of neurology gives you an opportunity to specialize it, isn't it? Thank you very much for your time and thank you for sharing your stories with us also. We wish you all the very best. And we wish your family all the very best. Stay safe, stay well, and let's work together to promote better brain health worldwide. Until we talk with each other next time, bye-bye now.
Thank you, Prof. Chisa. Thank you very much. Thank you.